Welcome to Preach the Word, Worldwide Network. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you so much for joining us on the Preach the Word show. You are in for an exciting time today. I'm telling you, the apostle, the woman of God, is in the house, and I'm telling you, she has blessed me already, and she's going to be a blessing to you with the word of God today. Help me welcome Apostle Deanna Dixon. Blessings, woman of God.
Thank you. God bless you. Amen. I am so honored to be here.
Thank you. Thank you for coming. I really appreciate you coming and just bringing the spirit of excellence with you. Amen. And bringing the glory in. It's just amazing when you meet people and just see the glory all around them, and you see the power of God activated in them. From everything that you said thus far, you've been a blessing to me. And I'm telling you, this great woman of God is going to be a blessing to you. Right now, I want you to get on the phone and call somebody and say, look, there's an awesome woman on the Preach the Word show. Her name is Apostle Dixon, and tell them to tune in. Well, woman of God, tell me, what's going on with you in this season?
Well, in this season, God has ordained me to be awakening to what God wants to do. People call me fire starter because everywhere I go, we're going to shift some atmosphere.
Come on,
because
now.
God says that his power is not relevant the way it should be.
Yeah.
You see, we talk the talk, but we don't walk the walk. Mm-hmm. And in Jesus' days, Jesus talked, walked, and performed miracles, signs, and wonders.
Amen.
Because he was connected to the Father.
Yes.
It's time for the church to get back connected to the Father.
Back connected.
You see, it's time to go back to basics. Mm-hmm. It's time to have that sure foundation. People are not rooted anymore. Mm-hmm. And so God is looking for some people that are rooted, because God wants to do some miracles, signs, and wonders in this hour.
Yes.
Oh, this is the hour of power, God says.
Yes.
His spirit is being poured out on this spirit, on this earth, like never before. God says that people is going to be healed and delivered. 2015 is going to be the year of revival.
Wow.
I'm talking about there's a fire. The supernatural has been opened up like never before. The spiritual realm is opened up. God is just looking for some Jesuses. God is looking for some Moseses. God looking for some Joshuas. God looking for somebody who will say yes and go. All you have to do is just say yes and position yourself. You see, God, the battle is his. Come on, somebody. The battle is his. But I tell you one thing. We already have victory. You see, you don't have to fight. You just have to position yourself.
Amen.
And people are not in position anymore.
That's right. They're
so
not in position. And you gave the answer to that earlier, as we were speaking earlier. You were sharing with me, and it was so profound to me the way you said it. And you talked about relations and relationship. Mm-hmm. Share that with our audience.
You see, when you first meet somebody, you have relations with them. And you know, they call it acquaintances, meaning that you know, but you don't really know them.
Right.
But when you have a relationship, this is somebody you spend time with.
Uh-huh.
This is some acquired seasoning. I'm talking about, it's like marinating. Anything that you marinate, you spend time with. And when you start spending time with it, you'll start knowing of that person.
Yes.
You start understanding their rules, their regulations, and what they expect. But a lot of people just have relations. They go to church, and it's a insulation. It's emotionalism. They just come in, go out, and they feel good. But the difference is that feel good, your flesh get excited, but ain't nothing happening, because when you get home, you go down for a crash.
Right.
But when that power of God do a relationship, something has changed. I'm talking about people will know it become, it resonate from the inside out. You see, the flesh and the relations is the outside in. Come on, somebody, just please your flesh. It's a little tingling. But you see, when you have a relationship, you're going to walk in that power that the source of that relationship is putting on you. Come on, somebody.
Amen. Well, people in the world understand what relations is, and they understand what relationship is. People in the world, when they have relations with somebody, it's just a little temporary thrill. You know, when I had relations with her, I had relations with him. But when they enter into the place of relationship, that's a whole nother ball game.
Yes, ma'am.
That's the seriousness of
yes.
it. That's the dedication of it. You know, that is the commitment
that's
of
it.
And I believe that's what God is saying. And I agree with you. It's time out for the relations. It's time out trying to get with God when you want a thrill. It's time out to get with God when you want something.
That's right.
But it's time for a relationship with God in all things in our life, the good and the bad. We know that God is with us.
Amen.
And we have that relationship with God intact,
That's
in
right.
place forevermore.
Amen.
And I
Amen.
Like that about you.
Amen. Thank you so much.
Amen.
And that's just the beginning. You know, I tell people all the time, you want the anointing of God,
yeah,
but you don't want to do what it takes to get the anointing.
That's right.
You see, the anointing just, come on, somebody. They thinking, you see, you could buy a degree, and you can buy even apostleship. Come on,
yeah,
somebody.
Come
you
on.
Can buy it, but the difference, what they don't tell you, is that don't come attached with that anointing.
Yes.
Either you got it or you don't. And the
right.
only way you can get the authentic anointing is by spending time with God.
Yes.
And then people don't understand, well, God, I want the anointing. God wants to know, can I trust you with my anointing?
Mm-hmm.
Can I trust you with my people? Because people have not always been trustworthy.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Uh-huh.
So this relationship, it requires a lot.
Amen.
And that's another thing people don't want to go too far. That's why relations, I can go in and out. I can go in and out. But relationship,
it
requires some change.
Yes. Yes.
You have to change some things in order to keep this relationship. That's like with a man or a woman.
Mm-hmm.
You fall in love with them. Don't things change?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, somebody. And then they even get a ring and say,
oh,
I'll
yeah.
marry you.
That's
well,
right.
It's the same thing God is saying. Are you supposed
covenant.
To be a bride? Come on, somebody. That's
covenant.
It. Covenant.
Yeah. My God. I believe you have awakened the spirits of some people where they literally have died spiritually. But I believe your voice today has awakened them up to wake up.
Amen.
And
Amen.
Hear the sound of the alarm, what
yes.
God is saying. He is not pleased with relations. He is looking for a relationship. He wants you to be serious about
yes.
your walk, because
yes.
we know it's more than just church.
That's right. That's right.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, people don't understand. Church was really made for us to gather in. Even from the tabernacle days, it was really to check in and see what was going on.
Uh-huh.
But the church really started when you went home.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the same thing that's happening. People are just coming in for a little temporary fix. Well, I'm going to go to church Sunday morning, maybe Bible study on Wednesday. That's a maybe. But they don't understand. After church is when it begins.
Yeah.
You see, your power is, what do you do when no one's watching?
Come on, somebody.
What are you doing? Because that's when God really takes notes.
Right.
You see, at church, everybody can put on a facade, and you can glorify, and hallelujah, and speak in tongues.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, somebody. But when you leave there, come
mm-hmm.
on, somebody. Before I left, my bishop on Sunday, he said, he looked at me Sunday morning. He said, Deanna, you look different. He said, that's because I said, I didn't already had church.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I'm just coming here to finish it.
Mm-hmm.
I said, but I've already had church.
Yeah.
So my whole point is, can you create the same atmosphere when you're at home? That's the anointing. That is what changes people. That's why people are not being healed and delivered. The church is not teaching people how to create the atmosphere at home.
Right.
And the way you can do that is with relationship.
Yes.
With spirit. God says, those that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. They don't know the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And so they can't receive truth.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, somebody.
That's good.
So relationship shows you the spirit of a
yes.
person and the spirit of God. But when you're in relations, you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You're just acquainted.
Oh, absolutely. Amen.
Amen.
You're on it.
Amen.
You're on it. And this awesome woman of God, Apostle, is about to preach the word in just a few moments. And we want you to hold tight, and we'll be right back for the word from Apostle, the woman of God. Hold on, we'll be right back.
Preach the Word, Worldwide Network, PTWWN-TV. We are now reaching the world. Preach the Word, Worldwide Network TV, PTWWN-TV. Call 850-656-6541 for more info.
Thank you for having me. God bless you. Preach the Word Network. Well, this is Apostle Deanna Dixon, and my message for today is, your order is really out of order, God says. I'm going to say it again. Your order is really out of order, God is saying. So I'm going to start off reading some from chapter Isaiah, chapter 1, verse 17, and that is, learn to do well, seek judgment, relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, plead for the widow, verse 18. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they should be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they should be as wool. Number 19, God says, if you be willing and obedient, you should eat the good of the land. Number 20, but if you refuse and rebel, you should be devoured with the sword, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. And so I'm just going to get right in there. Churches, People of God, leaders, let me tell you something. The protocol is not of God. It is time to let the Holy Spirit rule and reign the church once again. You're out of order, God says. I'm just going to say it. You're out of order. God is requiring order in his church. God says that judgment has begun in the house of God. Oh, let me tell you something. God is not pleased with this generation. This generation want to move in the flesh. And let me tell you something. You have mastered how to move in the flesh to where there's no anointing in the churches anymore. I remember 20 to 10 years ago when we used to go to church, where you could feel the anointing when you rested in the building, when you walked in the building. Now it's an entertainment field. Everybody want to be entertained. Oh, can you entertain me? But I don't want to be entertained. Teach me how to stay saved. Teach me how to walk holy. Y'all don't want to be holy no more because of your protocol. You're saved, but you're not delivered. And you wonder why people are backsliding. That's because your order is out of order. The Holy Spirit wants to reign in the church once again. When the Holy Spirit reigns, people are not only saved, but they're healed and they're delivered for real and not for play. We got to go back to basics. It's time to get out of this fame, money, the right thing. You kind of just want to go your own way, do your own thing. People don't want to be consecrated anymore. People don't want to be holy anymore. You want to do your own thing. And God told me to tell you today that he's not pleased. I say, God say he's not pleased. You see, when you love someone, you tell them the truth. And God is a God of love. So God is going to always put things in order that's out of order. And in 2015, God told me to tell you, revival is getting ready to come. And by the way, that is his church, by the way, and not your church. God wants to set order back into his churches. And how he does that is you have to repent. It is time to repent, go back to God and say, God, how do you want me to do this? How do you want me to run your church and also your people? Oh, we've had it wrong. For the last 30 years, you did good, God said. You gave us the word. You told us how to work the word. You told us how to walk the word, but what you did not teach us is how to walk in power. Oh, come on, somebody. It's time for the church to walk in power. The kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. I'm telling you, people are dying right there in the church because there's no anointing anymore. You wonder why you're backsliding. You wonder why you're fornicating. You wonder why you're lying. You wonder why you're playing games, because you have not truly been delivered. Because when you're truly delivered, everything changes. I'm talking about the Spirit of God changes your mind. You are renewed. Oh, come on, somebody. It's a relationship. It's not just relations. Because some of you saved, but you're not committed. You ain't been committed for years. You don't even know the word commitment. Come on, somebody. It is time for the church to regain knowledge and wisdom through God. And you can only do this by God, with God, and for God. Come on, somebody. The church has to come back. God said it's time. It's too much foolishness in the church. Leaders don't want to listen to nobody. Come on, somebody. Everybody got rules and regulations. It is time to come back and let God be God. Because if God is God, then let every man be a liar. And if this is true, then we have to go back to the oracles of God and not the protocols of men. I said in church the other day, and I pray that nobody get mad, but I missed it for years too. I noticed they did the worship. And everything was good, and then, you know, the spirit was high. But then they cut the worship, and they did the news, the announcements. And so God said, there it is right there, Deanna. I said, what are you talking about, God? He said, that's what's stopping me. He said, they round me up. They get the Holy Spirit started. He said, and then they stop me. He said, now I'm just sitting there. I can't even do what I want to do because they stop me. Let me tell you something. No man, no woman, no child, no beast, nobody can change somebody but the Spirit of the living God. But when you stop the Spirit of God, you have just quenched the Spirit. So now, then you go back and you try to minister. You try to do your own thing, not understanding that God is not even there. Because you have just allowed the Holy Spirit to flee. We got to get back. We got to get back to God. We got to stop the protocols. So much protocols. 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. You got most services. You look like a fast food restaurant, God said. And the food is stale, by the way. It's not even spiritual meat. Come on, somebody. It's that fake stuff. Come on, somebody. You got to keep on going. But I'm going to tell you right now, God is God all by himself. So you have to understand who you are and whose you are. God said, repent. Return from your ways and ask him. If you have trouble, just go ahead and get on your knees and ask God. God, show me how to get this through. But, and just because you've been a preacher for 30 or 40 years don't mean anything. Because if you ain't carrying no power, then all you is a person carrying the Bible. Come on, somebody. It is time. People are not getting saved. People are not getting healed. People are not getting delivered. And they're ready. People are hungry. People are hungrier than ever be. There's an awakening. There's a spiritual awakening in this earth that God wants to do. And he cannot do it because you have not done what you're supposed to do. So I pray that you've been blessed by this. I know I gave it to you in a quick and fast and in a hurry. But the whole thing is, remember, God is God all by himself. The fire of God has got to get back in the churches. Oh, let me tell you something. People are tired of just going to church. You just go. Come on, you're getting sick and tired of the same old thing, because I know I do. I just don't want to excite my flesh. I'm not here for my flesh. I got serious things I'm dealing with. I got a drug addict. I got a husband. I got a wife. I got a child. Come on, somebody. Feed me some spiritual food for real. Don't play with me in this hour. I say, don't play with me in this hour. I need God. I need the presence of God. People want the presence of God. People are tired of the shenanigans. People are tired of the entertainment. People are tired of the games. They want to know how to stay saved. How do I get from this level to that level? How do I get from faith to faith? How do I stop fearing? Come on, somebody. How do I get over drug addiction? How do I get over pornography? How do I get over sexual lust? Come on, somebody. It is time to take the word of God and what it is. It is a watered word. I'm talking about y'all been watering things for years, and now God is saying, stop it. Stop it. Stop it. God is saying, if you're going to feed my people or let them go. Come on, Pharaoh, because this is a new age Pharaoh. You are a new age system. You got the people more in bondage than they ever was in back in Pharaoh days, and God is not pleased. And once again, he's saying, let my people go so they must serve me in spirit and in truth. Because guess what? That is his people, by the way. Oh, you don't hear me. That's God's people. You are just an overseer. You are just a steward. You are not to think that that's your people. Oh, I'm telling you what God say. So if that's the case, then if you're going to be a flock, and if you're going to tend to the flock and you're going to be a real pastor, then pastor, God say. But if you're not, step aside and let somebody else do it. Come on, somebody. People are dying. People are dying right there in the church, spiritually, physically, emotionally. Come on, somebody, because they're not being fed the truth. Oh, you just water them down. More of you about money. Y'all became money. Y'all so about money. Oh, you don't hear me. Money and fame. You got more people wanting to be on TV to preach, but yet you ain't got no anointing. Come on, somebody. How you going to change the world? And you can't even change your own self. God is tired of this. God is saying you're out of order. Needs to get in order. And let me tell you something. Money's good, but favor's better. Come on, somebody. Anointing. Everybody know the true anointing. And people are liking the presence. They need the presence of God. Because in the presence of God, people change. In the presence of God, people heal. In the presence of God, people are delivered. In the presence of God, people, that they can take God home with them and say, okay, now I know how to do this thing. Teach me, pastor. Teach me. Teach me, apostle. Teach me how to do this thing. People are tired of games. And it starts with you. Let me tell you something. Everything you should be held accountable to. Oh, you don't hear me. Even what you do or what you don't do. What you say and what you don't say. God is writing it down. There's an angel writing down everything you do and say. So you are accountable for what you do and what you don't do. Come on, pastors, leaders. Come on. Something is wrong. There's no more healing. There are no more healing in the churches. As a matter of fact, some of y'all don't do altar calls no more. Y'all have forgotten about souls. Let me tell you something. The heart of God is love. If you have not love, then you are not anointed, and therefore you are not a child of God. You are a child of Satan, straight up. Yes, yes, yes. It is time to get back into the oracles of God by going back to God, going back to that threshing floor, going back to the oracles, to where God will lead you, God will guide you. Either God is God or you're God. Some of you have taken position of God. And God is not man, by the way. You need to stop playing with God. Some of y'all play with God so much. And I released something about 4 months ago, and I've seen 6 of them do it. Remember I told y'all that people are going to start dying in the pulpit? Well, there's been 6. And then y'all want to ask me why. Don't ask me why. Ask God why. Come on, somebody. God is not playing. We're in judgment. And a lot of people are taking it lightly. You should not take this lightly. Because God is serious about 3 things. His people, his word, and his wrath. Y'all talking about God is just a God of love. Well, I beg to differ. He's also a God of wrath. And if you defy the living God, oh, you're going to pay, because there's consequences. And you're telling people God is not mad. I hear so many of y'all talking about God is not mad. God is not mad. Well, let me tell you what God is. God is a God of order before he's a God of anything else. Read the Bible from Genesis to Revelation. He's a God of details. He's a God of order. He's a God of expecting what he expects. He said, if you be a willing and obedient, you should eat the good of the Lamb. He was not just talking about immaterial things, but he was talking about death and life. Proverbs 18:21, death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those that love it should eat the fruit thereof. Your words have been death. And God is not pleased. You're not speaking life to the people of God. You got people more oppressed and depressed and suppressed than they should be walking. I'm talking about having that water waking faith. I'm talking about it's time to arouse the people of God. And not just their flesh. Because they're going to get a crash when they get home. Come on, somebody. You're all excited. You know how we get in church. I'm talking about you're all excited. And then when you get home, you're still depressed. You don't know what to do. People call me all the time. How do I get over this, Apostle? That's because you don't have nothing in you. You have no word. And if you don't have no word, nothing can come out. Come on, somebody. You can't be sustained. You're not doing what it takes. And a lot of you can't just blame the pastors and the preachers, because some of you just go to church on Sunday. As a matter of fact, you don't open this Bible till Sunday. As a matter of fact, some of you don't even open it at all because you're looking on the screen. Oh, come on. They got the scripture on the screen. Come on, it's time to get in this word. It is time to work this word. It is time to believe this word. It is time to obey this word. You are acting like Sodom and Gomorrah, and God is not pleased. And what happened to Sodom and Gomorrah should surely happen to here. Come on, somebody. America is in trouble. America is in trouble. God said, we have sinned. And he said, the sins have reached the throne. Come on, somebody. And when the sins reached the throne, I actually saw in a vision, God was actually standing up. And God does have a throne. But when I say he's standing up, he's standing up. So what is God doing? God is saying, how dare they? I'm God. I'm God. I'm God. And one thing he kept telling me to tell y'all, he's not man. Some of you are still thinking that God is man. And you can talk to him like that. You can walk with him like that. And you can act with him like that. He's a holy God. And some of you won't even talk about holiness. You're walking around having people just come in your church any kind of way without the flesh. And that's another thing I got to release too. God said, put the holy robes back on. You're too much in the pulpit with flesh, and it is not of God. You got to go back. Oh, come on, some of you looking like a pimp. Some of you, those shoes are too tight. I'm telling you what God say. There's order. There's order. There's order in the house of God. There's order in the mouth of God. There's order in the spirit of God. Some of you have not the spirit of God anymore. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. It's time to get back. And God is a good God, because he'll always give you time to repent. Come on, somebody. He'll tell you to repent of a thing so you can get that thing right. And his arm is still stretched out after you've done all this thing and you're doing your own thing. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. There's some of y'all getting on TV and acting. I can't believe it. So some of these shows that show pastors and preachers and teachers, is that really of God? Come on, somebody. It's time for you to reevaluate yourself. The Bible says examine yourself. And the reason why God tells you to examine yourself, because he don't have to. You see, God already knew what you was going to do before you did, how you did it, when you did it. Come on, somebody. He just wants you to know you. Come on. It's time to make good choices. It is time to repent. The whole body of Christ needs to repent. And I'm part of it too, so that means that makes me too. We need to repent. We need to go down to the threshing floor and ask God, how do we get this right in the name of Jesus? How do we go about it, God? For we have sinned against the Lord thy God. It's time for order back in the churches. But y'all so focused on money. And then y'all lying to people talking about turn around three times, give me $20 and you're going to get blessed. Let me tell you something. You ain't getting blessed if you're not living right. Come on, somebody. Stop that lying to people. If they're not walking the walk, talking the talk, and doing the things that God said, they're not getting blessed. They're just giving an offering. Come on, somebody. Stop that. Then you got prophets on TV. We ain't going to say the name. Talking about Jeremiah 31, send me $31. That's not a prophet. You're a false prophet. Stop it. God is not pleased with that either. We don't do that. A true prophet do not profit, P-O-R-F-I-T, off the prophets or God's children. So stop it. You're out of order, God said. I'm telling you, God is not playing in this hour. You're going to see more than just people dropping dead. God said there's going to be fires in churches. So remember that. I'm talking about they're going to just catch on fire. Ain't nobody going to know how. But guess what? You know how. Because God is a God of wrath. And his wrath is here. Yes, he's a God of love. And he will still love us. But he requires some things. And holiness is one of them. And y'all don't want to be holy no more. Some of you like sin more than holiness. Come on, somebody. And if somebody tell you something, you're getting mad. If the pastor tell you something, you're getting mad. Because y'all got itching ears. You want to hear what you want to hear. But that's not that type of game. I'm telling you, God will tell you the truth. And the spirit of truth, for those that can hear it, let them have ears. For those that see it, let them see it. But you have a facade. You don't understand the spirit of God. It is time to repent, church, like never before. It is time to come back to God and say, God, I've missed it. I've missed it. So many people did it during the Bible, and God had pronounced death on them. But because they turned around and they asked God, God, I repent. Help me get this right. People were saved. People were delivered. That was a great awakening. Revival is going down in 2015 like never before. But first comes the great repentance. It is time for the church to repent. It is time for the leaders to repent. It is time for everybody to repent and turn from their wicked and evil ways. You don't do this thing the way you want to do it. You do this thing the way God want to do it. And some of you, you think that you, God, you want to do what you want to do. You think that's your people. I see a lot of you. You got these people so oppressed and suppressed and depressed. God is not happy with that. And you will surely give account because that's God's people in the first place. So I'm telling you right now, it is time. And I pray everybody get a hold of this message. This is not no doom and gloom, but this is the truth and the truth and the truth to set you free, God says. But you know people don't like to hear truth because they got evil good and good evil these days. But I care not because I'm going to tell you one thing. I'm going to do it how God said to do it. I'm going to do it. I'm going to say it how God said. And that's the end of that story. So God bless you. I pray that you're encouraged. I pray that you're strengthened. I pray that you walk in obedience. I pray that you walk in holiness. I pray you walk with the fire of God because it's the fire of God that's going to change people. It's the fire of God that's going to compel people to come to God. What are they looking at when they see you? Because people call you what they see. And some of y'all, we don't see no anointing. We don't see no power. So I want to know, what do people see when they see you? Because I ask God, hide me and let them see you. We got to get back to what people need to see. We're supposed to be ushering people to God, not to ourselves. That's the first mistake we made. This is not about us. This is about God. So let's take people back to the one that can save them, the one that can heal them, the one that can deliver them. In Jesus' name, God bless you all and be empowered. Because we walk heavy or we don't walk at all. In Jesus' name.
The Word Worldwide Network PTWWN TV. We are now reaching the world. Preach the Word Worldwide Network TV PTWWN TV. Call 850-656-6541 for more info.